I can't believe it.
Democratic activist Claudia Mendoza, born in Colombia, makes daily visits to heavy Hispanic voting locations.
Tu voto es tu voz. In Spanish we say that means your vote is your voice.
She believes the pandemic is turning more Hispanics to the Democratic side.
We are suffering so much.
Kevin Wagner with the FAU Political Science Department.
Any attempt really to group a group as large and diverse as Latinos into one voting demographic is always going to be wrong.
Says navigating the Hispanic vote is choppy at best.
Mexican Americans from Central America tend to be a little less associated with the Republican Party. Puerto Ricans that have been voting in Florida, many of them have registered as no party affiliation.
Meantime at Box Gallery in West Palm Beach.
I always tell people when they ask me what is the temperature of the Hispanic community, and I'm like, of which country and of which class?
Curator Rolando Chang Barrero is not stepping off the pedal.
There's a certain urgency from the Hispanic community.
He's also the president of the Democratic Hispanic Caucus.
Many of them have died or got sick because they didn't believe that there was an urgency. They believed the president that there was no crisis.
He believes that fear of being forgotten with COVID and otherwise will drive the Democratic vote.
Republicans seldom come around to acknowledge Hispanics until 1 or 2 months before the vote.
According to the Pew Research Center, a record 17% of registered voters in Florida are Hispanic. That's a slight uptick from 4 years ago. And Michelle, the importance can't be understated.
And in Florida, the Cuban vote sets the Hispanic vote apart from the rest of the country. According to the Pew Research Center, 54% of Cubans voted for Donald Trump in Florida in the 2016 election.
My view is that we have to vote for Donald Trump because he came from Cuba. We know what happened in Cuba. We know the destruction in Cuba.
What are the things about Joe Biden that makes you think about the communism in Cuba? Why do you feel like those two are connected?
Because the way he's talk.
Like many immigrants in South Florida who fled dictatorships, progressive, socialism are trigger words for Elaine Fandino. Those words are used in President Donald Trump's Spanish ads comparing Joe Biden to the communist regimes Fandino is all too familiar with.
I'm going to be good to go down as one of the most progressive presidents in American history.
We have to be scared of socialism. I remember what was happening to Cuba and everything coming from Cuba to Puerto Rico. And I have many friends from Cuba, Colombia. Venezuela was rich.
But it's not that clear cut for all.
In Palm Beach County, you have representation of over 21 countries from Latin America and the Caribbean.
Immigration, healthcare, religion, education, the economy, all rank differently for Hispanics even within the same nationalities.
There's a perception, and especially in the Anglo population, the custom has been always that one size fits all. Well, that's not the case.